down the rabbit hole wall mural part 2. If you skipped part 1, make sure you go back so you can see the full process on how I made this wall. I used the same black, white, green, and brown paint as the first video. I only use one brush for this part of the wall, and it's from Craftsmart. I used the Epson 3LCD projector. This came in handy for the scale and the layout of the image I used. I used Lysol wipes and paper towels to wipe away any mistakes I made. This is before I started painting the squares. The ombre base was complete, but I forgot to take a photo of it. Before I started painting, I made sure the image I used was scaled to the full size of the wall width. I also made sure it was the exact part of the image I wanted, since this image was very long. I used my iPad with the original image so I can reference the color, since it's hard to see with the projector on ombre walls. To achieve the colors I needed, I had to blend paint colors together. From this point on, I had to freehand paint since my projector didn't reach this area. This is where the iPad came in handy. I used it to reference the original image. I would go over the square lines multiple times to blend the colors together. For this part, I ditched my iPad and looked at the opposite wall for reference. I made sure to mirror the squares in the same direction as the other wall. This is the finished wall. This took about 6 hours to complete. This is just for the square portion, not for the ombre base. In total, for the ombre base and the squares, this took me about 12 hours to complete. Like and subscribe to my channel. More videos coming soon.